Hey guys, it's Chris again at Wahoo. Today we're going to be talking about using the Wahoo Fitness app for iOS along with your new KICKR or Snap. We're going to start with the bike already set up on the KICKR. If you need any assistance with that setup, just reference the video links below for the videos that we put together for you showing you how to do that. To start, check to make sure that the power brick and power cord are fully plugged in and that the green light is on. Next, check the red and blue lights on the KICKR to make sure that they're on and that the KICKR is ready to pair. Download the Wahoo Fitness app and double check to make sure that Bluetooth is enabled on your iOS device. Next, make sure that all the other apps are closed out on your iOS device by double tapping the home button and swiping up. Next, open the Wahoo Fitness app and tap on sensors at the bottom of the screen. If you don't see your KICKR on this page, select Add New Sensor and find your KICKR or Snap on the following page. Tap on your KICKR and select Save Sensor. If you're prompted to complete a firmware update during this process, select Yes to Accept and follow the steps on screen. It's also worth noting that only one app on a single device can pair with your KICKR at a time, so if you don't see it in this list, make sure that you close out all the other apps and turned off any other previously connected device. When you select Save Sensor, a prompt will appear to select workout profiles to add your KICKR to. Make sure indoor trainer is selected, tap Done. Tap Done on the next page, and now your KICKR is paired. Now that the pairing is complete, this will bring you to the main screen of the Wahoo Fitness app. To begin a workout, select Workout at the bottom of the screen. Make sure you see your KICKR on the next screen, and as well as any other saved sensors, and select Start. The first page that comes up will give you some basic info about the workout that you're doing, but if you swipe right, it'll give you a more detailed analysis of the data that you're receiving. And if you swipe again, it'll bring you to the four modes for controlling the KICKR or Snap. The four modes that our app uses to control the trainer are Level, Resistance, ERG or Erg Mode, or Sim for simulation. In the level mode, this is going to put the trainer into a mode where it's going to behave very similarly to a fluid or wind trainer, where the harder you go, the harder the trainer is going to get. In the resistance mode, this is going to be very similar to riding a spin bike at the gym, where as you increase the brake from 0 to 100%, that brake is going to remain the same until you change it later in the workout. In ERG mode, or Erg mode, this mode is going to keep the power output for the trainer set to the target wattage that you have it set to. As the cadence decreases, the trainer will apply more brake to keep that power consistent. The reverse is true. As the cadence is increased and you begin exerting more power, the resistance is going to decrease to keep that power output set to the target wattage. In sim mode, this will take into account the bike type, the slope, and the wind speed to replicate real outdoor riding. You'll want to make sure that your tire size and weight are correct in the settings in the app so that it accurately replicates those outdoor riding conditions. For more information on spin downs or firmware updates, you can find them in the video description below. Thanks again for joining us and getting your KICKR paired, and feel free to contact us through our support page for any additional questions.